H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Hi guys, good evening everyone. So hopefully everyone has joined, I think. Okay. So fine. So today we are going to start discussing about the new ecosystem called as PIG. Okay. So till now the topics that we have covered are, so is everybody able to hear me? Okay. Fine. Cool. So, till now we had discussed about HDFS, MapReduce, cluster planning, etc. Right? So the topics list left for our course are PIG, Hive, HBase, Scoop and Flow. Right? So from today let's start discussing about PIG. So the initial days when we started our course, during the discussion of our Hadoop ecosystems, we had just introduced what is PIG, right? So do anyone remember about what is PIG actually? At least on a very, very high level. So no one remembers. At least I'm expecting Rahul, Lakshay, Arjun and Nisha. Okay, good. High level data flow and processing framework. So Rahul is saying, and Akshay, it's not like SQL, but still I will let you know like what is the difference between PIG and Hive, because Hive basically is a kind of SQL, whereas PIG is a kind of a much more procedural language or a data flow language where you can think of like a PLSQL. I mean, I'm not saying that it is equal to PLSQL, but the difference how you see between an SQL and PLSQL is a kind of difference what you see in PIG and Hive. Okay, so it's not like I directly give some select statements or some only for fetching data, but here I can do much more processing as well. So there will be set of statements coupled together which will give you some particular output. It's not like a single line statement what we write in SQL. So as Rahul is saying, it is a high-level data flow language for processing any of the data that is available on our HDFS. It's not for processing framework, it's for processing data available on our HDFS. So again, data storage, the only way we have is HDFS, but for processing we have different ecosystems or different ways. I can do it through MapReduce or PIG or maybe Hive, etc., etc. Okay, I mean, whatever the topics that we are going to discuss in our class, I am just touching those ecosystems as well. But there are a lot many ecosystems, maybe more than 30 ecosystems where you have only for processing. But for all of them, the data storage is HDFS. That's it. So this is the single point of area where I can do or I can save some data. Okay, so let's start going through our so let's see a bit background about PIG. Okay, so the reason why PIG has developed is many developers did not have Java or MapReduce knowledge required to write standard MapReduce programs, but still they are in need of getting some analysis on data. So right now, if we take the students in our class, we are not familiar with Java, right? Most of us are not familiar. At least few of them are okay, or at least they were able to understand. But few of them, it's like a complete newbie where they can't understand, but still they want to work or get into Hadoop ecosystems. So the different ways we have, or the possible ways we have to step into Hadoop, is learning other ecosystems as well. I mean, not only depending on MapReduce, but people are in need of learning few other ecosystems. From a developer point of view, okay, we will be able to understand MapReduce and slowly we will cope up writing some MapReduce or Java programs. But what if we come to situations like we have data analysts or maybe business analysts or business scientists or something, or so we have few other roles in our current market. So for them also, the data analysis is one of the major part. But still, from their point of view, they were not aware of these development concepts. So for them, we have introduced a few other ecosystems where they can easily write some simple queries in the form of queries, and they can abstract the data whatever they are in need. So that's the reason they have introduced a new ecosystems on top of MapReduce, which is called as PIG. There is no full form for PIG. It's just like the name PIG was introduced because maybe you will get a laugh, but PIG is like, it will eat all kinds of data, right? I mean, it will eat everything. Whatever that was available to PIG, it will eat. So in the same way, PIG can be processed on any kind of data. So probably if you want to do some processing or unstructured data or maybe semi-structured data, PIG is a right choice when compared to MapReduce. So coming to the next point, Yahoo, which was the first big adapter of Hadoop. So PIG was actually introduced at Yahoo. So people residing at Yahoo, they were trying to do some analysis, and few of them have seen that it's very difficult, or it's taking a very big processing steps to do some analysis, at least some basic analysis also. It's taking a lot of time, and they started working on developing on a new ecosystem. So after few attempts, they have come up with a new ecosystem called as PIG. Hadoop gained popularity in the company quickly. So once PIG was introduced, people were more interested or more fascinated towards Hadoop, because it's not like a complex thing that they have to learn Java and then only they can step into Hadoop. So PIG is a simple or easier procedural language, or maybe you can much more think like a data flow language, which can be understood for more persons out of development concepts. So that's the reason people got started attracting more towards Hadoop once PIG was introduced. At Ahu, research team developed PIG to address the need for a higher level language to increase the adoptability of framework. So if you take MapReduce, first of all, I have to know the model and then I have to know the framework. Later on, once I understand the model and framework, I have to understand the programming concepts of Java. Or at least if not Java, any language, something programming language like C, C++ or anything I have to learn. So until and unless I have a programming background, I will not be able to step into Hadoop. So there were like much more complexities to do some research on big data. So that's the reason PIG was introduced, which is a kind of high level abstraction which sits on top of MapReduce. So right now at Yahoo, they were able to, most of them, they were doing like 30% of their jobs run on PIG itself. So I don't say that this is the only processing systems that were available in Hadoop, but this is also one of the good processing systems that were available for big data. It's not like it's a complete replacement for MapReduce, but the development approach, what we are going to do when compared to MapReduce, is different. So the just a learning curve is being replaced, but behind the scenes everything happens the same when compared to MapReduce. We will see how it actually works, but right now just understand that the development approach is only being changed. But internally, the execution, processing and everything will be happen in the form of MapReduce only. So it's like just the way data get processed remains the same. Okay, and also one more thing I want to mention here is, if you try to compare MapReduce and PIG here, MapReduce is kind of a master technology, where in PIG we can treat it as a subset of MapReduce itself. So whatever that is done in MapReduce cannot be always done through PIG, but the reverse is possible. So whatever that can be done in PIG and Hive, we can done it in MapReduce, but maybe it needs much more complexity or much more customization or MapReduce. For example, if I want to write a program in MapReduce, first of all I have to know. So if you take the steps in MapReduce, I have to know the framework, model, and then the input should be divided into input splits, and then the mapper face comes into picture, partitioner. So you remember, hopefully I think you all remember these things. Combiner, shuffle and sort face, and finally reduce face. Right? So totally there were so many steps that were involved in order to get an output for a particular data analysis. Right? That's the reason people were not much more getting interest on MapReduce. But here if you take, there will be very very less number of steps. But I will tell you what are the steps that were involved to write a PIG program. But for now, just think like the number of steps that were involved, or the number of processing steps that were involved in PIG were very very less. And in MapReduce, if at all I want to get some information, particular information, I use it to get it from libraries, right? But that's not the case in PIG. There will be no addition of libraries or nothing like that. There were few inbuilt functions where we can use in PIG, such that it will introduce that functionality into our PIG script itself. So I don't need to add any libraries. So even though you can think like MapReduce is also a kind of abstracted programming language, because there we are having libraries and interfaces where you can do much more abstraction. But still, if you want to write some complex program, it is becoming difficult to have it in MapReduce. So that's the reason people were looking for PIG. And the main usage of PIG is for data line, data pipelining or data cleansing. In the sense, whatever the initial processing that was required on my huge amount of data, that can be done easily through PIG rather than MapReduce. So if I say initial processing, it can be like initial transformation or analysis. Maybe suppose I have a video and I want to do some analysis on that video. Okay, so there will be few things that I don't need that information at all on that video. Maybe the click sounds or whatever the changes of font sizes from yesterday to today, or maybe some internal testing that was happening, or maybe the ads that were coming into my actual video. Before my video starts, there may be 5 seconds or 6 seconds ads, right? But I don't need them exactly for my particular data analysis. So all those kinds of things can be abstracted through PIG. So it's much more used for data cleansing as well. So that's what a bit about background on PIG. So we will see the definition of what exactly PIG is. It is a part of Hadoop ecosystem for processing data which is stored in HDFS. It's also, you can consider PIG as a tool itself for analyzing large data sets in parallel, similar to MapReduce. So as I told you, the processing is similar to MapReduce, but the things what you will see in the front end will be different when compared to MapReduce. In MapReduce, you will have to write a driver program, you will have to write a mapper program, and then a reducer program. At least these three things are mandatory. Apart from partitioner and combiner, at least few things that were mandatory to write in MapReduce to do some execution. But for here, there are no mandatory things. Whatever you want, you just throw it. There are no mandatory things or something like that here. Okay, compiles down to MapReduce job. So this is one of the important point. So whatever the program that you write in PIG, internally, once the PIG execution starts, it will be compiled down to MapReduce jobs. So whatever lines that you are writing in PIG, internally a jar will be created and it will be submitted to my job tracker as a MapReduce program only. Remember a blind point here, our Hadoop framework will be able to understand only MapReduce framework. Okay, it will not be able to understand anything else other than mapper, driver and reducer. So everything needs to be compiled down into MapReduce jobs only. Whatever the ecosystem you take, not PIG Hive or something else, maybe you go to some other ecosystems also, but internally it has to transform into MapReduce jobs because it is the only thing that our framework can understand. At least with the current version what we have in Hadoop. Maybe in the future we may get much more changes, but right now if you think, it can understand only MapReduce jobs. And even in PIG, you can write much more user defined functions as well. You can talk a bit about limitations of PIG compared to MapReduce with the I didn't get you, Rahul. I mean, you are asking about the limitations of MapReduce or limitations of PIG? Okay. So, for example, if you take the inverted index processing only, it's not possible in PIG. For example, if I want to get a particular word that is available in all the files, it's not really able to get everything in the form of key value pairs for me through PIG. But in MapReduce, it's very easier because everything will be thrown in key value pairs only. But if you take the example of joins or something else, in PIG it is much more easier rather than doing in MapReduce. Because for joins, again you have to run so many programs. For example, I have to write a mapper program for joining the data sets, and I have to generate the keys and a tag for joining those data sets, and then I have to write a combine function for those things as well in my MapReduce, and finally I have to get the output. And before I get the output, I have to check like what kind of joining I am writing, maybe inner join or outer join, and based on that I have to drop few things. So in that case Pig is much more useful. But when you take the things like getting data of how many files that were available for a particular word or those kind of things, MapReduce is the right choice. Okay, but still, I mean, once we go in depth, I will explain you the comparisons between MapReduce and Pig also, okay? So don't worry about that. Welcome. So, okay, where I am? Okay. So in Pig, I can use user-defined functions also. I mean, rather than writing built-in functions what are available in Pig, I can very well declare user defined functions also, which can be reused in my later parts also. Okay, we can see those things also. So it's like much more useful than the libraries developed for using MapReduce programs. So in the same way, I can develop user defined functions also here. But for few things, again as Rahul asked, MapReduce is the only way where I can do some image processing. I mean, I have to convert a particular video file into a PDF. At that point of time, I can do it only through MapReduce. Internally, I can convert it into binary systems, and then only I can convert into MapReduce. But if that is the requirement that was given to my Pig, it's very complex and it's very difficult, and I can much more say like we cannot do through Pig. So the map only jobs and all those things, whatever the examples that we had seen in map only jobs, those things can be done only through MapReduce but not through Pig. And coming to motivation of Pig. Okay, the first point is faster development. This is the major thing why people are getting fascinated towards Pig, because if I want to write a MapReduce program, at least I have to code 100 lines, but in Pig maybe all that functionality I can include it through 10 lines or maybe 15 lines. So the development phase or writing a Pig script is very easier. And the second one is MapReduce is a very powerful tool, but it requires a Java program. As we all discussed, the main drawback for MapReduce is even though it has many things it talks about, the only drawback for it is I have to know Java programming. At least if not Java programming, maybe some programming background should be there, C++ or C, at least for writing streaming jobs, I have to know them. One criticism of MapReduce is that the development cycle is very long. As you see here, the number of steps that were involved in writing a MapReduce, a single MapReduce program, is at least 8 to 9 steps, right? But here, the number of steps is very simple. And hence, we can say like the development cycle is very small for Pig. And also, I want to include one more point here. Pig is not suitable for all data processing tasks. Like MapReduce, it is defined for batch processing, but if at all I want to perform a query that touches only a small amount of data in a very huge data set, or maybe I have some 10 terabytes or 20 terabytes of data and I want to do some processing only on 1 terabyte of data, then at that point of time Pig is not a good choice, because it scans the whole data set whenever I write a script and submit it. And in some cases Pig doesn't perform as well as programs written in MapReduce also. So we will discuss those cases also. So coming to the Pig data flow, basically PIG is a client side installation. It is not part of Hadoop cluster. In the sense, PIG doesn't sit on Hadoop cluster. Like HDFS or MapReduce frameworks, whatever that are going to be get installed defaultly whenever I install Hadoop, PIG is not that kind of thing. So I have to install PIG separately, and it is going to sit on client system rather than cluster. So even though I install PIG or not, it's not going to affect my cluster. So my cluster will be in the same form. So basically, PIG is made up of two parts. The first one is PIG Latin, and the next one is PIG execution environment. So PIG Latin is a new language, and it is written in the form of scripts, and all the scripts will be given as input to my PIG system. So two components majorly. One is PIG Latin. It's all together a new language. Which is given as a input to my PIG system. And the second one is PIG execution environment. So there are two types here. The first one is local execution, which happens in a single JVM, and the second one is distributed execution on a Hadoop cluster. We will see the both forms. But for now, remember there are two different execution modes. One is local execution and distributed execution. And there is one language called as PIG Latin, which is altogether a new language which is used to write PIG scripts. Okay. Now, whatever we are writing in the form of scripts, we will be writing it in PIG Latin, and we will be giving it to input as a PIG system. So my PIG system sits on my client machine, and whatever the program that was given to my PIG system is converted into jar file, and all that will be get compiled on my PIG system only. Now once that was done, it will be given or it will be converted in the form of MapReduce jar. Once it is submitted internally, it will be converted into MapReduce jar, and finally it will be given to Hadoop system. So for cluster, it doesn't know how the program is submitted, means in which form this actual program is submitted. Cluster cannot understand that. For a cluster, it will be a basical input jar file that was submitted. But maybe that jar file might be produced through a MapReduce program, or maybe through a PIG script, or maybe through a Hive program as well. Cluster will not be able to understand that how the client has submitted the job. It can only understand that, okay, a client has submitted a job and I got a jar file which needs to be executed. Okay, let me start the processing and give it back the output to client. So that is the only thing cluster will be able to see, or it will be aware of. So that's what PIG provides, a higher level language called as PIG Latin. Increases productivity. The first point is the number of lines that needs to be written in PIG will be less when compared to MapReduce. Suppose 200 lines of Java will be equal to 10 lines in my PIG Latin. So that's what the main difference here. In one test, 10 lines of PIG Latin is equal to 200 lines of Java. Actually, before C and C++ were treated as low-level language and Java was treated as a high-level language, right? But these days what's happening is even Java is getting considered as a low-level language also, because so much of coding is required in Java if at all I want to do a small operation as well. So if you take the high-level languages that were created recently, you can take PIC as a high-level language when you compare Java, which is treated as a low-level language today. So whatever that took 4 hours to write a Java program, it is taking only 15 minutes or 20 minutes for me to write the same functionality or to introduce the same functionality through PIG Latin. So that is one of the main advantage. And the next one is, apart from productivity, opens the system to non-Java programs. So okay, fine, the number of lines that needs to be written or decreased, or the number of code that needs to be written is becoming easy. Apart from the productivity, data analysts are also able to analyze this huge data. So it's not like only a Java developer or maybe C, C++ developer is able to do some analysis. Even the business analysts or data scientists and data analysts were also able to start working or able to start processing something on their big data that were needed for them. And one of the major advantage in PIG is it provides common operations like join, group, filter, sort. These are few examples that I am showing, but there are many more built-in functions that were going to be built whenever I install Hadoop. So directly I can use the join function if at all I want to write, if I want to do a join operation. But if you take the MapReduce case, there is no built-in function for join, right? Because of that only I had written or I have to write a very huge program just to perform a sample join operation. So if you remember our customers table and orders table, just to get the information like how many customers are there for each of the order on a particular day, I have to write a very big program which include number of functions. But in case of PIG, it's just a built-in function where I can give the join operation. Like if anyone is aware of SQL or DB2, they will be knowing like how we will perform the join operation in SQL, how much it's easy to perform a join operation. So the same way we can write simple steps, maybe one or two steps to write this only join operation itself. But I will show you like how to write the join operations and all. But just for people who knows at least a basic idea on DB2 or SQL, for them they can understand like how much it's easy to write a join operation. And the last one is, it is a data flow language rather than a procedural language. So whatever we are writing, maybe in C or C++, we are calling them as a functions, and we will be calling internally as a function also, right? So we can use whatever the function that was written in our program again in another program through functions or something like that. But here it is just a step-by-step execution and no calling of PIG scripts or nothing will be there. So it's just only a step-by-step where we can understand it easily and process them much more better form. And coming to the installation part or distribution part, the version which we are going to be used in Ubuntu for PIG is 0.11.1 version. So it's up to me like which version I want to install on my Hadoop cluster. But the only thing that we have to keep in mind is whatever the version we are going to be installed for PIG, it should be compatible with my Hadoop version. So if you remember, we got the Hadoop version as something 0.11 or something like that, 0.7 I think, I'm not sure. So for that version, our PIG version should be compatible. So let me show you if at all I have. See, if at all you want to download something for Epic version, they will show you like this particular release will work with Hadoop release, release, release or something like that. So they are just giving, they are showing you the compatibility also before you download PIG. So if at all I'm trying to download my PIG, I'm looking for 0.111 version. And this version is compatible with Hadoop 0.20 of any versions. X means I can give it as 1, 2, 3 and so on. And also Hadoop 1.x, 0.23x and 2.x. So all these versions of Hadoop are compatible with my PIG release version, which is 0.11.1. So if at all you have installed any other Hadoop version apart from what we discussed in our class, just check for the compatibility before you download PIG. Okay. So this is the area where you are going to download. So everything, whatever that we are going to install in our Hadoop ecosystems, we will be downloading through our Apache Mirrors only. So go through any of the site here and you can download PIG. So I'm looking for PIG 0.11.1 version. Maybe it was last modified on 2013. As I told you, if you remember, it's always better to go a version at least one or two levels down. Whatever the latest version that is available, don't go for that version because it will have some bugs internally. So it's always go to, it's always better to go for a stable version. So I would be downloading that tar.gz file. So you can download this PIG 0.11.1 tar.gz file into your Hadoop cluster and then you can start working on PIG. So PIG is not the default system that is going to be installed on my Hadoop. So the only two things that get installed when I say that I have installed Hadoop is HDFS and MapReduce framework only. But anything else other than that, we have to download in this way only. Okay, so whenever you install Hadoop, just try checking whether the Hadoop, whenever you install PIG on your Hadoop, just try checking whether the installation has been done properly or not. For that, you can have a simple command called as this command. Should be, you should be able to execute this command if at all you have installed PIG on your system. So it's telling like Apache PIG version 0.11.1 have been installed here, and it's a sample command which shows you the help commands. Okay, so there will be help everywhere in any of the language, right? So like that only here, just try to give any of the command on PIG and you should be able to get these things. So then only you can say that PIG is installed on your cluster. So let me show you. So at this particular location, I have downloaded PIG and installed it. So once you download it, these are the default things that you would be getting after your installation. So again, in PIG also you are having a configuration directory. So it will just show you the PIG properties. You don't need to change anything on this, but it will show you whatever the properties that were available basically for PIG. So in order to execute any of the PIC program, you should be able to see this properties file once you download PIC. And the next one is point your bash rc file to PIC home. So it's like just instead of giving the whole path of user Hadoop inst Hadoop 1.0.3 PIC 0.11.1, I can directly give as PIC home if at all I declare this statement in my bash rc file. Okay. So that's all you have to change if at all you want to install PIC. And one more thing, if at all you are doing if at all you are going to install PIC in distributed systems, then again on your configuration files you have to give the machine IDs and all pointing to PIC. So we are not going to do it because we are going to run all this in pseudo distributed mode only. If you have more than one or three systems and you are going to form a cluster, then that is the thing we have to concentrate on. And the statements, I just wanted to show you the statements also. So whenever you download a tar file, the step that you have to follow is so I have went into this fifth step, which is download Hadoop distribution. We are at the same place, right? We have downloaded PIC distribution. So that's the reason I directly went to this step, okay? And all these things we already have. We have this user path, Hadoop inst path and all those things. So no need to follow these steps. The only thing that you have to do is extract the tar file. So you will be getting the tar file, and in order to see the contents of that particular tar file, you have to extract it. For that, the command you have to follow is sudo tar xzf. Instead of giving Hadoop 1.0.3, give PIC 1.11.0 or whatever the version the PIC version you have downloaded, give that version .tar.gz. So this will extract you the tar file, and once that was done, just give full permissions with the current user. So sudo chown or your username and then group name followed by your PIC version. Instead of giving Hadoop 1.0.3, give PIC 1.11.0. So as I told you, update the bashrc file. I had shown you the export statement, right? So update your bashrc file and you should be good to start working on PIC. So these are the only things that I see that you have to update in your systems. Okay, good. This particular position, right?
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free free demo class. Visit us at h2kinfosys.com.